Few days back, the Pan-African collaboration dropped. South African rapper Roche featured French rapper of Congolese origin Youssoufa and Ghanaian rapper Sarkodie in a track titled WhatsApp Group, WAG. In my opinion, a killer track which states the levels of the various rappers and reminds others of their place. Fans uploaded all of the verses, but a verse the Cameroonian blog 237 Showbiz decided to focus on was a verse from Sarkodie. They had this to say. Ghanaian rapper Sarkodie allegedly sent shots at Cameroonian rapper at Jovi on the song WAG by Roach. The person he is talking about on this song 100% matches Jovi's description, especially when he says, "Nigga, you have been tripping on Twitter page. You want to start a war, but you have been afraid." Nimboko God has been on Twitter rant in recent months, and a topic he has touched in numerous of his tweets is Sarkodie. Jovi has always talked of his lyrical superiority towards the Ghanaian rapper and has criticized the fact that the Ghanaian rapper always raps in dialect and not English. Sarkodie doesn't stop there. He sends numerous shots claiming to be extremely superior to Jovi, as he says, "You came in the game when I was already a legend. You're not even on my level. Regardless, we end close." Research shows that Jovi's Epukwa was released when the Ghanaian rapper had just dropped his Sarkodie album, and at that time had solidified his place as the best rapper in Africa and had penetrated numerous music markets like the Nigerian and South African music market. These shots came at a time when Jovi is on a low. They go on to ask, Jovi have something to say about this? Do you think Sarkodie isn't addressing Jovi but instead a different rapper? Do you think Sarkodie can murder Jovi in a rap beef, or Mboko no go die, ego only multiply? Okay, first of all, the first question they asked, will Jovi have something to say about this? I think Jovi has his moments. Definitely, he might not say anything about this because, well, it's not his moment to be out there and create any buzz, but definitely when he feels like it, he's definitely going to say anything about it. One thing I've noticed about Jovi is that he doesn't really respond when things are trending, except the Lyrical Joe time when he went at Lyrical Joe. Immediately things were said, right? But there are many times when Jovi just keeps quiet, like people say things about him and he doesn't say anything. Then when he's like about to drop a track or drop an album, then he responds to it and creates the buzz, right? So I think Jovi might have something to say about it down the line. Do you think Sarkodie isn't addressing Jovi but instead a different rapper? Now, I know like a lot of people might say, yeah, true, Sarkodie might be addressing a different rapper and not Jovi. Why do you think it's Jovi? He never called Jovi. Like, this is the age of subliminal diss. Like, a lot of these people, especially like people, rappers who feel like, okay, I'm too big to even respond to this other rapper. A lot of them don't call the rapper's names so that people, their fans can defend them and say they were not actually addressing that rapper, right? I remember when Calligraph Jones said, "Niggas in Sierra Leone, keep your name out of my mouth." At that point in time, like, his fans could not definitely say he wasn't talking about Cal Denuru, because like, which rappers in Sierra Leone have openly like come at Calligraph Jones but for Cal Denuru? So you cannot really dispute that, right? And it's true what the blog said. A lot of the things which Sarkodie said in his verse definitely matches Jovi. The whole Twitter thing, I remember when I was listening to the whole verse, I was like trying to think of other rappers that I've known have come at Sarkodie. You know, being big in the game, definitely other rappers will come at you. Rap is a competitive sport. You saying you're the best, a lot of people want to prove themselves the best instead of you. But definitely the description and the things he says definitely matches Jovi. But there are some other things which you could say, well, he is openly addressing everybody who has ever come at him, whoever came at him. Definitely, if he's openly addressing everybody who has ever come at him, then Jovi is one of those people, right, who have come at him. So indirectly, he's still addressing Jovi in a way, right? So I, especially what he said, other things, and I was like, it can be general. He can be addressing people generally, but when he said the whole Twitter thing, I know Jovi has really been hard at Sarkodie a lot of times on Twitter, you know. Maybe not specifically Jovi, but Jovi is one of those rappers who have come at him, so indirectly he's also addressing Jovi. If he's addressing everybody who has come at him, so he's addressing Jovi too. So do you think Sarkodie can murder Jovi in a rap beef, or Mboko no di die, or Idi only multiply? What do I think? I think it's very hard for me to describe, it's very hard for me to judge Sarkodie's lyrical ability because he raps a lot in the dialect, which I do not understand. So it's very hard for me to judge that. But I know Jovi is a crazy, a mad lyricist. He's very good lyrically. So for now, I'll go for Jovi. Yeah, maybe I'm supporting my own, but also I would say I cannot really judge Sarkodie lyrically because I don't understand him. So Ghanaians, in the comment section, I know you guys are going to react to this. you understand Sarkodie and listen to Jovi's track. Now you guys judge. Let's keep the fact that okay, I'm from Ghana and I'm from Cameroon. Let us know what you think.
Thanks for watching that video. Hope it inspired you to want to commit to Chakara TV. You want more content from us? Don't worry, we got you covered. All you need to do is hit the subscribe button, hit the notification button, then sit back, relax, and enjoy daily content from us. It's been Eta on Chakara TV. We are craziness with a strategy.